What's up, business builders? In today's video, I want to give a review of Shortcut, the video editor that I use. It is a free open source software. So without much ado, let's head on over to the screen. So Shortcut looks pretty blank at the moment. And one of the things I like about Shortcut is that it doesn't overwhelm you. If you are just starting off with editing and maybe the dark theme doesn't really suit your taste, right? If you are using, say, from Movie Maker, Shortcut has the ability to switch themes to a lighter theme, right? So if you prefer a brighter theme, you can choose that. Or if you prefer the professional video editor look that have a dark theme, you can also do that. So this is one of the options that's available in Shortcut. One of the things I like about Shortcut, and I think it is very useful if you're new to video editing, is that, and I still remember this when I first jumped into professional video editing software, right? You see all the kinds of windows up there that it feels so overwhelming and you do not know where to start. Okay, now Shortcut doesn't have that problem because when you open up, the screen is pretty blank and it seems like as if it is just a video player or a media player rather than a video editor. But you can actually open up panels or windows as you start editing, and I find that if you are new to it, it really helps. Okay, now obviously there are filters, right, to put effects, and you click it open to open up a filter, right? If you want to add a filter, I can do that. And there's a timeline. By clicking on the timeline is at the bottom. Let me just show you how to move the video, right? By just clicking on the video there, this is shown on the timeline. And Shortcut allows multi-track editing unlimited. I can add another video track. You can add audio tracks, and this is what I like about it, right? So transitions are there. For instance, to split the video is very simple. All I have to do is just move my video playhead to the place that I like, click on S on the keyboard, and the video clip is split, right? And transitions are as simple as dragging and dropping it into the other side of the clip, so you see a transition. Now one of the other things about Shortcut is that Shortcut has the ability to do audio scrubbing, right? Scrubbing is a point when you want to cut your video to an exact position, right? And when you perhaps you can hear it, let me see. Okay, in this video clip there isn't much audio or voice, so you probably can't hear it very well. But scrubbing is when you drag your playhead over a certain spot and you know exactly which point you want to cut. When I record my videos, sometimes I say a wrong word, okay, or I may paste or I may pause too long. So that by using the scrub function, it allows me to cut off the pause exactly where I want to cut it. Okay, so and this is one of the things. And creating a multi-track recording is also simple, right? You can do have this similar clip on here again. Let me just show you. Okay, you can overlay the track on another track. You can add music. You can add audio, right? All those are available. It is pretty simple to use, and exporting the file is also quite simple, right? There are many options when you want to export. For example, HD, you can even export it to H.265, which is even a more highly compressed format in case you want to keep your videos. So there are, okay, in terms of the sound, let me just close the panel. In case of the sound, there are meters that you can see, you can use as you play it, right, to monitor your audio settings. There are also audio filters, like for instance, you want to normalize your video track or you want to mute certain sections. All those are there as well. Creating picture-in-picture effect with Shortcut is also not an issue, and actually once you get a hang of it, it is pretty useful. Now what are the cons of Shortcut? Now Shortcut is a free open source software. It's being developed actively and new features are added. So at this point in time, one of the things that is still lacking is keyframe filtering. For example, if you want to create a zoom effect, right, a motion zoom, imagine you have a scene and you want to slowly zoom into a certain section. That is not available at this point in time, but it is on the roadmap. And the other thing is that there are some occasional crashes, which is pretty common for most video editing software, but you need to save your work regularly to ensure that in case a crash like this happens, all your work will not be lost just like that. So Overall, I'm pretty happy with the Shortcut. I was actually on the verge of paying for a software, but Amazon doesn't allow me to do a download because of my location. And I looked around for quite a while for a free video editor and I came across a Shortcut. There you have it, my quick review about Shortcut. If you are looking for a video editor, if you want to step up from a movie maker, Shortcut is actually a good option. Or perhaps you don't edit that many videos and you feel that paying for paid software, like some of the software you need to subscribe to it monthly, and that fee is a little bit too high, then Shortcut will be probably be something you would like to give it a go. The other thing about Shortcut is that it doesn't have any limitation. You don't have any watermarks, right? You are not limited to export in say 720p like some of the so-called free software. There's low limitations on the video. And in fact, Shortcut can be used across multiple platforms. I hope that this video has been useful for you. If you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure that you click on the Get Notified button and you will be notified every time I release a new video. You can also head on over to my website at jameswu.net and be the first to be notified in case of anything I found interesting. This is James. I hope that you are taking a small step to building a better business each day.